ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to another episode here on Pasticheofskin. Can you tell what we're doing today? Can you possibly be able to tell what we're doing today? We're playing Heavensward, but what we're doing is the Starlight Celebration. So yes, every year I play the Starlight Celebration in Final Fantasy XIV. Even if I am not playing the game itself in my own time, I'm not actually getting around to playing it very often. I haven't played Final Fantasy XIV in almost 8 months. 8 months since the last time I've actually logged in. But last year I had so much fun doing the Starlight Celebration content that I want to do it again. So I'm back. I'm back again. Shady's back. Tell your friends to do the Starlight Celebration. I love the Starlight Celebration because it is such a fun little kind of like side story content that comes up at Christmas. It feels festive no matter what. So we're bringing Britain back. Britain Longbow is back alive again. Coming to the steps of Ald to actually bring some festive cheer. What I need to do first is make sure that I have my Christmas gear on. So we're going to sort that out. But this is going to be not a long play, but it's going to hopefully be an complete play of all of the content that you can do in a single day of the Starlight Celebration. Now, I've been talking to people who are good friends of mine that play this game still constantly, and they've made it clear to me that it's not possible to do it all in one day, because each day that you do it, each time you go iterate it for each of the days, is going to release more content or a Norse story to be told. And that's cool, that's absolutely fine. I'm glad that it's a proper kind of like continual seasonal event rather than actually being like something you come in and play for a day. But yeah, I'm going to have to solve that problem as fast as possible. So as you can see, we've already got our festive decorations up. Isn't it looking pretty? Looking so pretty! Look at the steps of Ald. And there's a lot of text going on here, so let's see. I don't have a keyboard hooked up. So I can't even completely clear everything off of my screen to actually show the nice stuff. So I might go in and close off a few events, or close off some of the events that I have listed here from me playing it previously to actually free up some screen space. Let's see, see what I can do. HUD layout. Hotbar. What hotbar I'm worrying about. Oh, there's so much stuff on the screen. Minimap. No, this is main menu. Duty list. Yes, duty list. Let's make you I can't make you disappear, can I? Right, I've got an idea. HUD layout. There must be a way to actually hide all. Oh, it's so long since I played this game, I don't even know the menu systems of it anymore. System configuration. HUD. There must be a quick way to turn off the HUD. HUD copy. No, that's not what I'm looking for. I'm looking for HUD removal. this is going to be frustrating if I can't get it sorted out very quickly. Is there anything I can do in here to actually do the HUD? Cycle HUD components? This is not good. Well, looks like we're going to have to do a fight. There's no quick and easy way to remove all UI components. Right. Well, either way, we'll figure that out as we go along. I'm sure there'll be a little bit of... If any of you guys are actually in the chat watching this live stream, feel free to tell me if there's a quick way I can remove the HUD components. I probably should have just hooked up the keyboard and did the... use the shortcut keys I used to use for actually removing it in play, but I'm stupid. I decided to start the stream without even thinking about that. So where would you need to go? So I was looking up the information for the Starlight Celebration, and from what I could tell, it is in the Steps of Nald that we have to start the mission. It is in the Uldal Steps of Nald. So we need to get to the Steps of Nald. I think this is the way. This is the Steps of Nald, isn't it? Yep, there we go. See, right? You see? Even though it's been 8 months, still there. I still got some of the knowledge left inside me. My rotations? Sweet fuck all of that knowledge is kept. But at least I know where I am. So, I mean, it's looking wonderfully festive. I've always loved the music and the experience of online worlds whenever they actually do the seasonal thing. I'm just going to pump the audio a little bit so you guys can enjoy the festive tunage. Oh, is there... a mission giver around here? There has to be somebody. Steps of knowledge. So essentially, I know it's the steps of knowledge that I'm actually looking for, so where be they? Must be down here, just on the end of the street. Oh, there we go. So just exactly in the same spot as they can tend to do for the Halloween and all the other missions. So who is this? I'm Granaggi. Naughty or nice? Tis the season, and I'm Granaggi seeks a kind-hearted soul to help her work miracles. This quest is available for a limited time only. Alright. Well, if it isn't my favorite miracle worker from the Starlight's past, might you be so kind as to lend me your ald once more? It would mean the world to the children.
Aww.
As you know, the Starlight Celebration is a time to celebrate the children of the realm. Our home is our future. Our hope, our future. As a Starlight Celebrant, it's my sworn duty to see happiness and good cheer duly doled out to all the boys and girls, particularly those whose daily lives afford them few reasons to smile. To that end, I've planned a special delivery for the young'uns at the Children's Ward at Frondale's Fronistery, but I fear things have hit a snag. The parcel has vanished. I trust it has only been misplaced and not stolen. What black-hearted wretch would deny these children a rare moment of good cheer? I would search it for it myself, but I fear my duties as a celebrant keep me from leaving my post. Might you be so kind to go look in my stead? Oh, of course we will! Oh, thank you. Should you find the parcel, pray deliver it directly to the registrar at Frondale's. I have my heartfelt gratitude for your assistance, and remember, it's not just me that's counting on you to work miracles today. Oh, yay! Now, I'm looking pretty dark for a festive cheer bringer, so I think I may need to make a quick stop. Right, we're going to run in here. Do I actually have my sprint even? That's the thing, I'm sitting here looking at this going, like, do I actually have my sprint even, like, attached to my character here? Oh, God, there we go, thank God. I was like, I'm looking at the, do I actually have anything actually put in for this? No, that's Ruby Road Exchange, that's not what I'm looking for. I need to go in here. And I am going to go to my room. Do I actually have a room here? Can I get into the room here? What the hell? What's this? It must be some kind of side quest. Quicksand proprietress. Yes. I want to talk to you. No, that's not what I want. Inkeep. There we go. I need an in-room for the moment. Thank you very much. Alright, so we're going to stop into the room. We're going to pick ourselves up our festive gear, our festive threads from the armoire. Remove an item, and we need our seasonal gear. Not summer, not winter, not a yukata. What we need is our tunics. Ah, there we go. Right, so we need that. We need that. We need our starlight. We need our saint's beard. Do I need the saint's cap or saint's beard? I want to go saint's cap. And I'm the gloves, antlers. And, I'm not. Well, we'll go with a headband. Antler headband. That'll actually go really well together. I think we're going to leave the beard out this time, and we'll just go with the hat. So, let's get ourselves ready for Christmas! Alright, so where are we? And... boop! And... boop! And... oh, we don't have a belt for Christmas. And where's our starlight tights? There's our starlight tights. And our starlight boots. And do we have anything else? No, we don't have anything offhand. We don't have anything for the ears. No necklaces. We don't have rings for it. Yep, that's us. Ha ha!
Don't we look festive?
Alright, I think we may have to actually abandon beard. It's just a little bit too creepy, considering that I'm bearded and now Britain's bearded. I don't want to compete with my own beard. Yeah, let's remove an item. Oh no, a store item. No! Oh, controls of a menu screen. Saint's cap. Yes, there we go. Got that. I have to take it off in character. It's a top hat. And we'll put store an item. And we'll put in... What? No, not equipped. Head. Since cap. What? The legacy warrior meal? Oh, right. Sorry. I was wondering there for a second. I was like, going like, where did I get that from? We don't have a cap otherwise, but what we do have is antlers. Where's the antlers? Give me my antlers. There they are. Yay. Isn't that more appropriate? Okay, so let's get ourselves out there and let's bring some cheer to the goddamn children. Oh, man. This does make me feel joyful and prepared for Christmas. I mean, I intended to do these videos so much earlier than now. But it was one of those things where I just couldn't find the opportunity to get into Final Fantasy XIV to play this. And I'm so glad that I'm sitting here with a quiet drink in my home for Christmas Eve playing this mission. So, yeah. It feels appropriate in a lot of ways. If there was like Christmas content in every game that I owned, I would probably play it today. That's the truth of it. I'm not a festive Christmas person, but I am a... I feel seasonal joy. This is probably the best way to describe it. So what are we looking for? We need to go to... for the special delivery. So where is it? Okay. Not a bit nice. We find more information. Where is it she told us to look? Search for the special delivery. Did it say anywhere that we need to go? That you set forth for the Ruby Road Exchange in hopes of delivering such much needed joy. So where is it? Okay. So we're right here. Right. Maybe we try the delivery moogle, see what the crack is. Nope, new letters. Nothing for me to find. Who do I need to actually talk to? Oh, that's right up to my store. Oh, wait! Look! Turned around, it was right there! Awesome! Take a little sip for victory. Hey, where are you taking that crate? I hid it there for a reason, you know.
No, you shouldn't have hidden in the first place.
It's, what? I saw the market and I assumed it belonged to one of the physicians from the children's ward. I was only trying to have a little fun, I promise. I didn't mean to cause any trouble, honest, at least not for you. So just take it and do whatever you want with it, and don't tell anyone you saw me here, okay? I don't want to get in trouble again. I love that the sign of ascent in the Final Fantasy XIV universe is... because that's pretty much my entire childhood, my entire life. It was like, right, bud, lad. Alright, so that's that gesture. That's the driver's gesture whenever you pass somebody in the car. It's either, or, That's how well actually you know them. If it's somebody you really know, it's... But, yeah, that's beside the point. So where are we going next? Not a bit nice. Deliver the special delivery to the raven-haired redster at Frondil's front of the... Too drunk. Completely too drunk. So where are we? We need to find this place. And where is that? Steps of Thal. Okay. We need to go to the Steps of Thal.
To the Steps of Thal. Let's help.
Let's help all the children. Let's help all them all. Let's help all the children. On the steps of a thaw.
Right, hang on. Where? So obviously I've got two missions here that are actually going to the same place. So where am I looking for?
Ugh. Oh, stop doing that. Up.
There we go. Find what we're looking for. Where am I going to? Okay. So I need to go to the Alchemist Guild. Okay, that's easy enough. I was trying to remember what the name of Frondale's was. That's my own fault. Stop auto-running, you idiot. Right, so we'll just take the Aetherite shard and get ourselves there quickly. Alchemist Guild.
Quick teleportation!
Greetings, adventurer. You have a delivery for me?
Yes, I do.
Thank the heavens, when the goods the celebrant spoke of did not arrive at the designated time, I feared the starlight would be a lonesome one for our poor children. Pray tell, whatever did it disappear to? I see. Thank you for your honesty, and fear not. We will not punish the boy. The younglings here do not live easy lives, but they have good hearts. I shall do what I can to see that they all have cause to smile today. On that subject, may I ask one more favor of you? I realize we have troubled you enough already, but I am certain that it would bring the children no end of delight if you would not be adverse to helping us. Pray speak with me again. Nero!
We got a new robe. New starlight robe. How does it look? Oh, that's gorgeous! That's sweet! It's beautiful! I like it. I'm gonna wear it.
So, moving on.
The Raven-haired Registrar would like to make a special request of you.
Let's see what he got for us next.
So you will lend us your aid? I cannot thank you enough, friend. As for the task at hand, I would deliver these presents to the children, but I fear they would find little joy and wonder in receiving them from a fusty physician whose face they see every day. But one of the saint's little helpers, on the other hand... Behold, I have the garb right here, and I'm certain it would become most becoming of you. My colleague at by the door would be happy to show you into the children's ward whenever you desire. Meanwhile, I may look into the matter of that mischief-making boy. Thank you again, my friend. When you see the children's smiles, you will know just how much your kindness meant to them.
All right.
Hello, alchemist.
The Restor has told me everything. And we thank you for your charity and adventure. It would be my pleasure to show you within. There's the children's ward. This is going to be sad. Sick children at Christmas. What nice. Genteel child. Hello, genteel child.
Well, if it isn't the little helper, might you have a present for me? Oh, please say that you do.
Of course I do. It's a little starlight gift just for you.
Heartfelt thanks to you. I can only hope that the spinner hears my prayers, that I might spend next starlight with my family.
Aw. Aw.
Well, that's sweet.
Huh. Alright. Well, kiddos! Hey, kiddos!
Hello there, little helper. Might you perchance have a present for me? For the little old me?
Yes, of course I do, little child. I don't know why all of you have English accents. It feels very festive, doesn't it? So, Christmas Carol!
Oh, but you're truly too kind. I feared my letters would not reach the spinner from here, but I see how my worries were not worth for naught.
One of these has to be an angry kid.
Pardon me. Do you have something for me?
Yes, I do, child. Ho, ho, ho! I bring children gifts all the time!
Oh, thank you. I'm so happy. I'll get better by next starlight. Just you wait and see.
Aww, he's sick. Where is the sick kiddos? There's another one. Who are you? Pallid child. Oh, no. Don't be so sick.
Little helper, do you truly have a present for me? I must be dreaming.
Here you go.
Oh, thank you so much. This is the best starlight ever.
You've successfully delivered a gift to every youngling on the premises. One present, however, still remains.
No sick child die! No!
You have my thanks, adventurer.
Hearing the laughter of the little ones, I see you served as a most splendid little helper. But pray tell, do you perchance still have one present in your possession?
Of course I do!
I suspected as much. Currently, we have 5 younglings residing with us, but one of them, a boy by the name of Robert, seems to have slipped outside unintended. No doubt this is the self-same boy you met not long ago, the boy who stole away with our starlight gifts. But whatever you
would possess him to do such a thing? This is no time for idle speculation. We must find him before he comes to harm. You will aid in our search, won't you, friend?
Okie dokie.
Once again, I am in your debt. Let us begin our search at the Ruby Road Exchange, where you last saw him. I will await you there.
Yay! Okay. Well, not yay. Kid's gone running around. He's probably sick. This is not going to end well. Just not right. He's just not well. Leave the children ward.
Just for the moment.
Oh. I need that for my voice. So we're back to Ruby Road. Well, no, I just need to go back to Ruby Road. Yep. Scholars Walk. Ruby Road Exchange. Crap. Nulled. Get to Nulled. Take you to the Ruby Road Exchange.
Bum, 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 bum.
What the hell? Oh, shit. Gates of Nulled. Not the Steps of Nulled. Wrong place. Running back. The Steps of Nulled. Aha!
Loading, loading, loading. Festive times are loading.
Oh, where am I now? Ruby Road, Ruby Road, Ruby Road! Quickest way to Ruby Road? I think this might... That wasn't a smart move, was it? Get an all, get the Sultan, airship landing. Crap. Okay, hang on, we'll run there fast. Run, 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 run. Steps of Nulled. Nope, wrong place. Steps of Nulled. That's where we want to be. Ugh. Right. I'm having difficulty navigating just because of my own idiocy. Not because of anything else. Is that? Mimi gun. I was just looking at the gun. I thought a minigun was actually the chocobo keep of this area. Cut in here, quicksand, and we go around here. And we're out. Not this door. Is it this door? Hey! Problem solved. Hello, kiddo. Happy Festivus, sicko. But that doesn't sound right. Whoops, knocked something over on my elbow. What is this? Oh, father, father, can we stop at the stall before we go home? We told your mother when we would be home by the next bell, did we not? You wouldn't want me to make her sad now, would you? Oh, I suppose you're right, father.
Well, I suppose she would not be devastated if we stopped off at one stall. Bought her a little gift? What do you say?
Yes, father. Father.
Who goes... Oh, you're the adventurer from before. I've been a good boy since then. I promise.
It's alright, kiddo. It's alright. We understand.
Except for running away, I suppose. I'm sorry. I didn't mean to cause you any trouble. Between you and me, I don't particularly want to go back, but I wouldn't want you to get in trouble, too, so I will.
Good on you, kiddo. You made the right choice. You made the right choice. So...
What did I do now? Somebody think of the children!
Okay, I need to get back to... the Raven Herd. Ah, there he is. It's up here. Easy. Find your kid, man. Find your kiddo, and he's way back home.
You found Ravan. Convince him to return, you say? You truly are a miracle worker, friend. Come, let us return to the children's ward. I simply must get to the bottom of the boy's most curious behavior.
Okay, dokie.
Let's get back to the phylactery. Yep, at the children's ward. So, teleport to the phylactery.
Ninja teleport!
Where is the nearest Therosite? Damn it! Therosite me! No, there's one nearby here. Okay, I think the nearest one is actually in the next screen. Oh, There we go.
Sprint like the wind.
I really should have completed the ninja so I could actually have, like, a faster natural step speed, but... Mm. Doesn't the tree look glorious? Glorious trees! Glorious lights! Oh, so festive. Damn it, I wasted my sprint. Come on! Ah, a theosite. There we go. Thank you! Oh, let's go. I've got the hiccuperies. I'm going to the phylacteries to get rid of my hiccuperies.
The Red Star has told me everything. We thank you for your charity, kind adventurer. It would be my pleasure to show you within. Let's enter the children's ward then.
Ah, there he is. I keep changing the English accent the guy does, but either way.
How many times must I say this, Revere? I do not mean to scold you, merely to keep you safe. I just promise me you will not go running off like that again. Everyone cares for you here, and this behavior of yours causes no end of worry.
Liar! Nobody cares about me! I could die tomorrow and no one would shed a tear. So just leave me be, will you? Revere!
Dear heavens, I'm sorry you had to see that, friend. I know what this boy is thinking these days. Revere!
Man down! Man down! Child down.
Why are you so sick?
Worry not, friend. The boy's life is in no danger. I have already seen to his treatment. He should be back on his feet ere long. And yet, it is fortunate we're close at hand. Why, if he had collapsed but a few bells earlier, on his own, out on the streets, I mean... If you have a moment, I would speak to you in private. Pray come with me. Bouvier's illness is not an especially complex one, but one of the herbs used in its treatment is quite rare and not easily come by. As such, his time in the children's ward has dragged on longer than any of us would have hoped. Moon after moon spent in the company of strangers, it would not be easy on any child, let alone one as sensitive as Rovier. And yet, he has fought his illness with admirable courage and nary a word of complaint. That is, until recently, for the life of me, I cannot fathom what has turned him into such a rebellious, sullen child. I only want to help him, and yet I am at a complete loss for ideas of how I might do so. Alas and alack, whatever am I to do?
Essentially, listening to your problems is actually how I completed the event.
Fair enough.
Alright, let's keep on hearing what your story is. I don't know what's next.
The Raven-haired Red Star is lost in the depths of despair.
Okay, well, obviously we need to go and hunt down this shit.
Alas and alas and alack, is there nothing I can do to bring succor to the poor boy? Am I doomed to stand idly by as he descends further into a pit of hopelessness, self-loathing and despair? My apologies, my emotions got the better of me for a moment. I often tell the children that even the most potent herbs and potions will not avail a patient who does not possess the firm belief that his condition will indeed improve. This is time true for myself as much as the truth of... It is true for myself as much as it is true for my charges. Sadly, in the case of poor Rivera, he seems to have all but given up hope. I cannot fathom what's happened. He used to be such a sweet, sanguine child. I beg of you, friend, pray help me help the boy. Might you investigate into the matter, that you might ascertain what ails his heart so?
Alright.
Thank you ever so much, my friend. I shall go speak with my colleagues at the
The pharmacy. From now on, it's a fucking pharmacy.
The frontisserie, to see if they might have any insight. Mayhap you could speak with one of the children after your efforts as a little helper. I imagine they'd not be shy to share with you anything they might know.
Genteel child, come hither. Tell me about the other child.
You'd ask of Robert?
Very well. I see him reaching under his bed the other day as if he were hiding something. Of course, I did not peek. I'll have you know that mother and father instilled me with the finest of manners.
Okay. You didn't peek, but you obviously know.
Dainty child. I saw Rivera reading a letter the other day with a terrible grimace on his face. Mayhap something in the words upset him? Or perhaps his sickness is acting up again?
Coughing child.
Rivera? He hasn't seemed too happy lately. Who can blame him? Or I just think of how long I've been here, so far from home. Sometimes I can't help cry too.
Robert?
Now that you mention it, I haven't seen him smile much lately. We used to laugh together all the time. I wonder what happened.
All right, Robert. You tell me the goddamn truth. What the fuck is wrong with you? Oh shit, you're already still past that.
I found his letter! Found the letter! Somebody! Letter! Letter! Letter? Who did I take the letter to?
Oh, to the Ravenhead Register. Where are you? In your office. Okay. There you go.
Ah, oh, welcome back, my friend. Have you gleaned any insight as to what ails Paul Revere's heart?
Well, possibly this letter, filled with horribly personal information, might actually shed a light on the subject.
What have we here? A letter. To Revere from his father. Well, I'm loath to intrude on the privacy of my ward, despite desperate times call for desperate measures. Let us see now. My dearest son.
I promised I would be home for Starlight, but I felt the business calls. I fear the business calls. Pray forgive your father for this broken promise and know that I shall return to your side as soon as I'm able.
I should have known. Revere's father is a merchant by trade, and his travels often take him to distant shores. Few things instill the boy with hope like his father's visits, but they have grown increasingly rare. Doubtless he prayed to the spinner for his father's return for Starlight, and was devastated that those prayers went unanswered. This letter is the cause of his recent malaise. I fear there is little we can do to lift his spirits. Unless we could somehow find the man and convince him to... Wait, I believe I know someone who just might be able to come to our aid at a time such as this.
You mean me, Ryan? You mean me? Me?
Well, go ahead and investigate the matter. Pray, join me anon at the Hastings Strip. I will explain there.
Alright. Fair enough. That's a lot of hardworking healer? You're baking cakes! That's not healing! That's adding sugar to their diseases. Goddamn diabetes. Okay, where are we going next? Obviously, we're leaving. Stop picking things.
Rendezvous with the...
I wonder what we're rendezvousing with next.
Rendezvous with the Ravenhead Register at the Hastings Strip.
Hastings Strip. Where is Hastings Strip?
I'm almost sure I know where that is. Oh, right. Well, the airship... So that's airship landing. Is that the Chamber of Rule? Okay.
To the Chamber of Rule! Teleportation! The easiest way to cheat. Fuck that guy! Fuck that little bastard! Fuck him! That's who I think it is. Fuck him. No likey. No likey to fuck.
That the motherfucker that poisoned people? I hope it isn't him. I feel bad if it is. I'm judging people by their facials, but he reminds me with the mustache and the fucking...
Our friend, your timing is impeccable. With some help from an old acquaintance, was able to ascertain the whereabouts of the poor boy's father.
That guy's a fucking killer!
The acquaintance of whom I speak? An old friend from my departed mother's, and one with a vast web of information at his disposal. He was more than happy to assist for the right price, needless to say. But you needn't concern yourself with that, friend. What's important is that we found our man!
Fuck you, Raven-haired dude.
As my source tells it, Rivera's father is staying over at Limsa Lominsa, awaiting a vessel that will take him across the seas to Radzathan in the east. If we depart now, we might still catch him before he sets sail. I would go myself, but you must understand, I simply cannot leave the poor child entrusted to my care, and so I must call upon your generosity again as the starlight season. Pray travel to Limsa in my stead, the Rivera's starlight wish may yet come true.
Well, okay.
So, I need to go to Limsa Lominsa?
Aye.
Right. Travel. Teleport. Limsa Lominsa, lower decks.
Follow me. Stay here. Get him!
Sorry, I'm just doing a whole bunch of, like, impressions from Ibs, Odyssey, and Age of Exodus while we're waiting. Sure you find that classy.
So where the fuck do we know next? Follow the arrows.
Oh. Alright, just looking at the designs of characters. Just noticing how people have changed the way their looks. Armor looks awesome. Anyway, moving on. I need to go to the ferry docks, so I'm pretty sure I can just teleport to the ferry docks from here, can't I? If I find the goddamn aetherocyte. Run like the wind! Ah! Stop! What? Don't remember. Ugh. So, let's go to the ferry docks. Ferry docks. No. That's a ferry docks I want to go to. I'll just run it. Looks like we're doing it on foot. I'm gonna wander through Lominsa's shopping arcades, just enjoying all the wares that are available. And probably should check to see if any of my stuff sold in the summoning bells. Okay. Continuing to walk, we're almost there. Almost there. Hey! It isn't just the guy we were looking for.
Why, yes, I'm Bear's father. Whatever is the matter? Has something happened to my boy?
Very, very, like, young-looking for my voice I'm doing for him, but who cares?
It can't be. I knew the boy was looking forward to the Starlight reunion, but I think a single broken promise would ravage his heart so. You must understand, friend. I want nothing more than to fly back to Uldal to Rivera's side, but I simply can't. No, a matter more pressing calls me across the sea. It's not merely a chance of profit or fortune that calls me eastward. I've at long last found a reliable source for the rare herb needed to cure my boy's disease. If I do not sail out on the next ferry, it may be moons, even years, till I find an opportunity like this.
Well, I completely understand. How about I go?
And so, as much as it pains my heart, I must go. I know not if it will suffice, but pray deliver this to my boy in my stead. It is a memento I had meant to give him when I returned from Radzathan.
Send me to Radzathan. I'll go fight and find these things. You fuck off and see your kid.
Take it to him and tell him this, even when his journeys carry him to distant lands. Your father's heart is ever with you. With that, I must prepare for my journey. Thank you, my friend, and happy starlight to you.
Well, ain't that cute?
I've just realized something. Where did I put my pen? Pen. I hope to God I didn't mute my audio. I didn't do that, thank Christ.
I'll be home for starlight.
Is the name of the next mission that we have to do. Show the present from Robert's father to the raven-haired register. So we... Motherfucker, I'm teleporting right back? No, no, no. No, 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 no. No, no, no. Why go into no? Eh. Got money. Might as well spend it. Not like I can afford a house in this game. I could even afford a room in somebody else's house. Well, I wonder if that actually would be a way to make money in this. Oh, house that you rent out people. That's something that they haven't done yet. Although, admittedly, the whole point of the housing system is to actually generally, like, bleed money out of people. Where am I going? I am going... this way? Oh, Raven-haired Father. Where is he? If I do this, I can find where the nearest fair side is to him. Oop. Ah! Are you serious? Oh, he's on Husting Strip. So, the nearest one is the Alchemist Guild. Alright, fair enough. Grand. I just need to find an Aetherocyte now. Which is... oh, God. Oh, dude. Rasafrasin. Right. Where is the goddamn Aetherocyte? I'm just gonna run up here and find one. I wish the dancers would change their dance at Christmas. Just for something a little bit more festive, you know? Maybe. Maybe that's an idea for you guys at Square. You know, just kinda change that one little thing. Yeah. Since you're gonna happen every single year. I'm not saying happen you dance every single year. I'm just saying have a dance that you could actually have for Christmas. Nervous nanny? So, let's go this way. Dum. Dum. Dum, 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 dum. What? No, I'm not going to the Coliseum. God damn it, that's an honor mission altogether. I want to go to the Alchemist Guild. The Alchemist Guild, the Alchemist Guild. Here we are at the Alchemist Guild. So many people in the same place as I am. On behalf of my colleague, I would like to thank you once again for your generous offer of aid. Should you wish to enter the children's ward, you need only speak the word. I keep forgetting the voice I keep giving this guy, so it may change a little bit from part to part of the episode. I've got horns! Look at me! Yeah, she's looking very lightning-esque. I like it. I really like that outfit. Ooh, very shiny. Anyway. You return, friend. But if you return alone, did the man elude your search? I'm losing the accent that I was meant to be using. I think this is it. Is this actually close to what we were doing? Maybe. Close enough. Close enough? Close enough. I see. I can only hope that this gift will serve to rouse Revere from his doldrums. Pray take it to the boy, my friend. He should be back on his feet any time now, and given his recent behavior, I suspect he would rather receive the present from you than me. Okie dokie. Give me the shit, I'll give it to the kid! Hey, little fucker! Here's a gift! Oh, you're back. I've been a good boy, I prom... what? You have something for me? What is it? Is it a horse's head? A present? But the only thing I asked for, Starlight, was... a present from Father? His heart is always with me, you say? That's a stupid lie. If his heart was with me, then why isn't he here? Like he promised he would be. Please, Robert, you must understand. Your father cares for you more than anyone we know. Then why didn't he come back? Why is he sailing off to some distant land?
His coin's so much more important than to him than his own son?
It's precisely because you are so important to him that he sails east, my dear boy. He sails out in search of the rare herb that will cure you of all ills, that you might live as family once more.
You're just making things up, or aren't you?
I swear on my own father's grave that I am not. This adventurer heard as much from your father's own mouth, didn't you, friend?
Yeah, pretty much. That's all I heard from him. He actually said that and then ran off.
So, Daddy doesn't hate me after all?
On the contrary, Rivia, your father just wants to see you well again, as we all do. You promise that you'll stop fighting us and work with us to overcome your sickness.
You bet. I will. I'll get over this and be back, living happy with my dad in no time. Just you watch me.
Success, kid!
Now that's the Riviera I know.
May we speak in private for a moment, friend? I'll be at the front desk, if you might spare a moment.
The fuck does he want me to do now?
Present! I'm stealing your present, kid!
So, what do y'all want?
Ya raven-haired lunatic? Demeliod, you insufferable dolt, I swear, can I not leave you my bumbling erstwhile apprentice alone for half a bell without him turning the cauldron over and making a right mess of everything?
Master Severin, whatever brings you to the children's ward at this hour of the day?
Are you deaf, dumb, or do you simply enjoy being intentionally obtuse? It's as I just said, you spectacular fool. I saw you running around town like a chocobo with its head removed from its body, and I deigned to interrupt my far more important research to see if my surpassing knowledge might be needed to rescue you from whatever miserable plight you've surely inflicted upon yourself.
That's most kind of you, sir, Master Severin. I'm pleased to inform you that, thanks to the charity of this kind adventurer, the situation was resolved a few brief moments ago. I'm quite sorry to have, troubled you, so...
What's this? Your face is unfamiliar to me, and I'm not particularly inclined to waste my time getting to know you. But whoever you are, it would appear that you're more competent than my erstwhile apprentice's job than he is. I kid. Yes, my apprentice. He may be sappy, sentimental fool, but I suppose it's something to be said that the children's ward hasn't entirely collapsed under his stewardship. Though I dare say my regular visits have something to do with that. Wouldn't you say, Director?
Master Severin, your guidance is, as always, most welcome, but should you be taking this much time away from...
Good gods, Dominion! Whatever are you wasting my valuable time when you know full well that the pressing experiments demand my constant and undivided attention? I swear, the next competent apprentice I find will be the first. That guy's an asshole. I mean, seriously, you run a children's ward, he's an asshole, right?
Forgive me, friend, my... not intruding... introducing myself sooner. My name is Dominiot, and I serve as the director of the institution, though in fairness it is simply a position I inherited from my departed parents, and that I even now struggle to prove myself worthy of. Nevertheless, on behalf of all my colleagues and their children placed in my charge, not the least of which is dear Rivera, I offer my most sincere thanks for the boundless kindness and charity you have shown us this starlight season. In my own childhood, I was a patient here myself. I suffered from a most curious ailment. Whenever I drifted off to slumber, I knew not where I would again awake. It was only through the benevolent and goodwill of those around me that my condition did not at long last abate. And so it was that when I came of age, I resolved to carry on my dear parents' life work, and that I might do my part to bring succor and solace for those in the greatest of need.
a simple motive, mayhap, but one that more than sufficed. But I have rambled on too long enough. I thank you once again for your kindness, friend. You are welcome in the ward whenever you desire. I am sure your presence would bring smiles to the faces of the children.
Well, obviously, we completed it. Starlight Celebration, Orchestra and Rule?
I got music!
Awesome. I like that.
Daily quest is now available from the Dominion in the Children's Ward.
So, the daily quest is obviously what other people have been saying each day you need to do if you want to get all the things. So, ladies and gentlemen, that was the main Starlight Celebration content. This year it feels a lot, I don't know, not slower? But, I suppose, Jesus. Feels like that person just like cast a spell and made that person change clothes. Okay, it feels like, I may have completed the main content for this particular bit, so we'll see what a Starlight story is, and maybe that'll be us for the day, because, or not for us for the day, but for us for the Starlight season here on Final Fantasy XIV, because that was a sweet story, but obviously, it's daily content, so we're not going to be able to play this over and over again. So this could very well be a single video. I think that's probably what the case is going to be. Just double checking our runtime. Yeah, we're grand. Oh, I'll do this bit as well, same part. Demia beams an exuberant smile on your return. This quiz is available for a limited time only.
Why not?
Ah, adventurer, your return hardens the children and me as well. I know we have imposed on your generosity quite enough already, but I was wondering, might you be willing to spare a few moments of your time? In your travels across the realm, surely you have seen wondrous sights in which children in my care could scarcely dream. It would be an ever so special starlight gift to them if you could regale them with a tale of your adventures. What do you say?
Okay. You want to hear about me killing shit? Ran! I killed it with this book. Killed it with another book. Killed some other things. Beat the shit out of a few titans. Subjugated a couple of them and made them actually my little pets. Well, I know about that. That's absolutely fine.
Oh, thank you, my friend. I am certain your story will bring them no end of wonder and joy. I will gather the children in the innermost room. Pray meet us there when you are ready to tell your tale.
And the tale of ages begin. Once there was the Big Bang. The world came into existence, and it was not quite good, so we blew it up in another bang, and then the realm was reborn.
So we're going to tell the tale. Robert? Is that who we're telling it to? Okay. You tell us a tale, kiddo.
It's her, everyone. So, what story will you tell us today? My friends and I do love a good tale.
What is the tale of? Let's find out.
Holy shit! We get to pick one!
Fuck yes, we're doing about the primals.
Well... Adventures in Gridania. I do love the stories of what happened in Gridania, and the chocobos get involved in that, and I'm pretty sure there's going to be different things for each one, but I'm assuming each one of these is a specific gift for each day of the event, so maybe it might be worthwhile me quickly looking up which ones are which. That'll be a good idea. So, let's see if I need a Starlight 2016. Nope. Too many numbers in there. 2016 stories. And see if there actually is a specific difference between each one of them. Starlight stories. Starlight FF14. Because apparently Starlight is anything for a bunch of people. Starlight story. Daily quest! Yay! So, Starlight Story, begin to tell the choice story for your many feats of prayer and doom, invites you to retire for the well-earned rest, and the summary greeted by the dreams, which could only be one of Senna's little helpers. Okay, well, I don't want this to be ruined for me. I just want to know if there's a difference between each of the stories. It doesn't seem to tell me on the 14 wiki. But I'm sure there's somewhere in here that'll tell me more about this. Okay, so essentially each one of them brings up a NPC for each one of them. And I wonder who I'd like to be visited by. Okay. So. Matters on the people. So, how far you're playing the story matters on what you tell about each place. So, essentially, I can look to see which person I want to see. So. So, Tataru, Alphinod, Nanamio, Ilnamo, Thancred, Papiamo, Anilda, Yestola, Saint Nemea himself, Godbert Manderville. So, I imagine Manderville being the first one would be actually probably the first one to go with, but I really want to see somebody in particular. People who run great nations would be the ones probably in most interesting. Stola I do like as well. You know what, actually, I'm going with my hometown for my character. So the adventures in Limsa Lominsa. Yestola was one that I actually associated with that, and I'd be more interested in hearing stories about what I've done there that might be of interest. So let's go with the adventures of Limsa Lominsa.
As I was telling the tale, I've been upon down these giant beasts in Limsa Lominsa, and it was under danger a lot, but whenever I took from the port of there, I actually went and fought this giant snake demon that was a primal or sea demon.
Oh, thank you, my friend. Or thank you, friend. What? That was one of the most exciting stories I've ever heard. Well, everyone, I told you her stories would be the best.
Indeed you did, Robert.
Friend, your tale was such a rousing one that when I closed my eyes for a moment I could swear I was journeying at your side. But as is of the case, joyous times pass swift of us all, and the hour grows late. What say you rest here for the night? This room is empty at the moment, and you have more than earned yourself a respite. I shall see you on the morrow.
Alright, fair enough. I'm going to sleep here with my glowing nose. My glowing nose is going to keep me up all night.
Bum-ba-dum. Is this where I level up now? This is where I get all my XP? Where's my bros? I need to actually sit down and camp for the night. Istola!
It would seem you have done good this year. So I come, bearing a gift from the spinner. Do not ask why she chose me. Surely this gaudy frock would better suit Ida or Tataru. Still, it calls to mind one starlight many summers ago, when I awoke to find a small ribbon beside my pillow. Master Matoya took me to task when I suggested she was the one who placed it there. Still, I knew the truth, and was rather moved by the gesture. But I have to dwell on the past long enough. The dawn comes and I am summoned elsewhere. Be well, friend, and do not neglect to look beneath the tree when you awaken.
Istola! I love you, baby.
Oh, that's so goggy. I got such a blocked up nose. Why did I wear this all night? Oh, God. Who hasn't?
I feel a little bit better now.
Presents! Just tearing the paper off. A scene sent gift. I wonder who I have to give this to. Hey, you! What the hell is this?
Good morning to you, friend. Did you, you say there was something waiting for you under the tree?
Yeah, this motherfucking thing. Is it a bomb?
Well, well. Might it be the miracles are afoot and the Saint of Nemea himself has visited us personally to bestow a gift on one of his favorite little helpers. But forgive my jest. The children were so stirred by your tale that they simply insisted that they were to deliver in some way. And I was all too happy to oblige. Pray accept it as a humble token of our gratitude from all of us at the Children's Ward for the kindness you have shown us this season.
Alright, fine. In your dreams, you say? Well, that is most fascinating indeed. Mayhap the sound of me tiptoeing into your room at night stirred your imagination as you slumbered? Or mayhap, well, suffice to say that this is a magical season. I would not be the least bit surprised if the spinner herself sought to repay you for the miracles you have worked. At any rate, I thank you once more from the bottom of my heart for all you have done for the children. Should you have the time and inclination to share another of your tales, I'm certain they would welcome it with ears and hearts wide open, as would I.
All right, I'll take that gift, and I'll tell you another story tomorrow. Hey! So, I have no idea what the hell was in that gift. Inventory? Starlight gift box. No matter what wonders await inside this festive package, always remember that during the season of giving, it is the thought that counts. Oh, so you can use it and there'd be something inside?
Interesting.
So, is it actually a randomly given gift? I'm curious to find out what's inside it. I can't see what's actually inside the item. It doesn't say any of the items. So it doesn't tell me what's actually inside there. That's weird. So there is just the robe that I'm wearing currently, which is of course absolutely gorgeous. I love it. It's really nice. Thank you very much. It is delightful. Thank you. But I'm trying to find not the gates. I'd be better off just running back, shouldn't I? So yeah, that's the Starlight Celebrations content. Now obviously every single day we'll have a slightly different comment from each one of the characters and different events all happening. And that's really nice. That was actually quite sweet. The main tale was a little bit sad about the kid and his father not being able to connect each other again. But yeah, that was actually very enjoyable to play through and read through. I felt for the kids. I felt for the characters. That's not where I wanted to be. I'm going down this way. Ow! 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 Gold court? No, that's not where I'm going. This is the gold court. That takes me to there. I think this is the way I want to go. Yeah. So yeah, that was a sad, slightly heartfelt story, and I'm very glad that it actually was told. And the telling your tales of your own experience of you actually playing through the game and actually like telling tales of your adventures. I really do wish it actually did the cutscene. Like if each one of them would actually like be a cutscene that you've already played and through and unlocked and told them the tale, that'd be awesome. Oh, look at that! Yay! That's the bullshit! That's awesome, that's cute. I love the logo! Aww. I love the outfits people actually have. Somebody actually like changed the color of their festive wear? That's crazy. Alright, cool. So I'm gonna take a wee look down here. Oh no. Oh no. Oh no. Fursuits. Do we really need fursuits in a world where we actually have catgirls? Okay. So anyway, obviously, there is. We have our gratitude. We're going to take a look at the celebration prior, see what little bits and pieces that they have. Greetings, friend. Are you enjoying the festivities? Should you have any questions regarding the Starlight celebrations, you need only say the word. I know all that. That's perfectly fine. I'm actually looking to see what these suppliers are and what they might have, like bits and pieces wise. This is a Starlight pillar, furnishing for the home, a wall mounted Starlight poster, and outdoor furnishings. No pies, no food, no random shit. Motherfucker, what the hell, man? I love getting the little bits of, like, winter cookies and that kind of shit. Those are always awesome. Well, I suppose what I'm going to have to do is open my, that's not what I wanted. I'm going to have to go into my inventory and open my Starlight gift box and see what is inside it. So, gift unboxing now! That?
Spirit bond energy is transferred to an item that by its maker during the crafting process. Okay. Demi materia. Not really, you know, a really interesting item. I mean, I'm glad to get the Starlight Celebration music. But that was that's a bit weak. That's the thing. This is not about this. It's not about taking big items. It's not about character related events. It's about the gift of giving, it's about the joy of the holidays. It's a happy time. Oh. What? Oh.
Oh. Oh, you're awesome! Thank you, Shilvara. Oh, thank you. Shilvara Osiris. You are a badass! What? You're awesome! Yay! Oh, that's so cool of her! Ginger cookies and all things awesome. You are now my favorite person. Yes! Oh god, how do I add you now? That is actually pretty cool. Oh, somebody actually came over to give me a cookie and a mulled wine. That is really, really nice of them. That is really, really cool. These are the spirit of Christmas, man. That was not planned. That was not expected in any way, shape, or form. Oh. That was so, so cool. Just a completely unexpected, really, really sweet little gift from a random person who was actually sitting there. Yeah, joyous Starlight, that is... yes. I can't... How could I do anything more than that? How could I actually be any more exemplar of how nice and how cool the people of Final Fantasy XIV are at Christmas at Starlight, where all the love is there? That is absolutely badass. That says absolutely everything about the season that I could possibly say in this video. So I can't follow that. What am I going to do with that actually at the end of it? Oh. This is why an MMO community is actually wonderful. It's actually part of if you're there all the time. Even if you're not there all the time, it's really welcoming. It is joy to actually take part whenever people are all working together. And of course, it's Starlight, guys, so happy Starlight celebrations to you. This has been Pasticheofskin. It's been an absolute pleasure. Thank you very much for watching. Of course, I will be back again with episodes very soon. If you like this experience, if you enjoyed watching me play through it, hit the subscribe button up there, and you will see more stuff like this in the future. Stuff like this makes me want to stay in the MMOs forever. Over here, there's some stuff that I've actually worked on this week otherwise. And remember these people's names because they're bringing joy to the world. A warm little gift of a time. So until the next video, happy Festivus, and I will see all you dudes in the next video. Bye.